Dear students, how are you? I think you are very well by the grace of Allah, and I hope that you are enjoying our online class. I advise you to follow this class. This class will be very helpful for you, as we don't have any time to take our class through classroom, and we don't have any opportunity to come to our school. Okay, dear students, in your home, you should enjoy our online class. And you must think that this is our classroom, okay? And from this online class, you can get all the topics that we will be discussing day by day, okay? Dear students, thus today we will discuss the topics on voice changing. It's essential for the student class 6 to 10. Dear students, for voice change, you have to have the idea about tense. Because without tense, again and again I am telling you, without tense you cannot continue or you cannot advance yourself. For advancing yourself, what should you do? You have to revise the rules of tense again and again. If you have forgotten the rules of tense, you will get no benefit. Because tense means the period of completing action. Suppose active voice, passive voice is of two kinds, active voice and passive voice. Just first rule is that if you want to make the sentence from active to passive, you have to know about the subject. Suppose I eat rice. Here you should remember, this is subject, this is verb, and this is object. First rule is there, object must be subject, rice. Then you must use the be verb. According to the tense. Okay, tense according to the tense. This is present indefinite tense. And for present indefinite tense, you can use is, rises. Then past participle form of main verb eaten. Rice is eaten by me. So what should we think? We should think the sense of a verb. Just you should try to write down active, passive. Suppose if you see its present indefinite tense, that means main verb. Here you must use am, is, are. Present continuous tense, that means am, is, are plus ing. Here you can use am being, is being, are being. Present perfect. Have, has. Plus main verb 3. Main verb 3 means the past participle form of a main verb. Have been, has been, have been, has been. Past indefinite means First form of main verb. Was, were. Past continuous. Was, were plus ing. Was being. Was being, my has been past perfect, past perfect had, yeah, had been. Then future indefinite, future indefinite, future indefinite, shall oblique will, shall be oblique will be, future perfect, but future continuous, vehicle of future indefinite, now future continuous, future continuous shall be will be. Here we must use shall be being, will be being. Future perfect shall have, will have. Future perfect shall have, will have, shall have been, shall have been, will have been. Okay, these are the primary states. The primary stages that you should follow, or you should try to remember this. And without this primary idea, you cannot go through the voice. Voice changing is very simple, very easy. But you must follow, you must try to remember this sense from active to passive according to the tense. If you don't have any idea, please try to cover this. Okay. Next, I would like to tell you some best examples that will help you a lot. Suppose you see single subject and two subjects. I did it for you. I have sent him someone. These are the two examples. I did it for you. I have sent him some money. Here, I subject, did member, it object, for preposition, you prepositional object. I did it for you. So if you see any preposition before any subject or object, you must avoid this to take as a subject or as an object. So what should you do? We should take this subject or this object as a subject. Did. It's past independence. Did, past independence. So instead of past independence, we can use was or were. For it was. It was the past participle form of did, done. It was done for you by me. Okay, it was done for you by me. I have sent him someone. Here two objects, him and someone. This means a person and this means him. You must take this subject, him, he. He has been sent some money. He has been sent some money by me. Okay, dear students, you must see that past participle form have. Here have, instead of have we can use has been. Instead of did, we can use was. So can you imagine the importance of tense? Again and again I am telling you, you must try to cover the topics on tense and the sense of auxiliary verb from main verb to be verb, from main verb to be verb. And another example is that in the classroom, in the classroom, I will take your classes. You must think that in the classroom, it's an extra word or words. That means it's a phrase. It's a phrase. This phrase must be unsensed to sense the voice from active to passive. Here subject is I, auxiliary verb will, main verb take, your classes is an object. So what should you do? You can take the object as a subject. Your classes will be taken by me in the classroom. And if you write in this way, in the classroom, your class will be taken by me, it's also correct. Okay, dear students, what you will learn, you must try to learn this very clearly. It's my advice, and you must remember this. Thank you all.